Hello and welcome back to another character creation video. My name's Lumin and today we're having a look at Blazing Sails. Fight for survival in Blazing Sails, a fast-paced pirate PvP game. Create your own unique pirate and ship and band together with other players to command your mighty vessel. Explore different game modes, maps, weapons, ship types, and more while eliminating other crews in epic battles on land and sea. So yeah, it's like Sea of Thieves. It even looks quite a bit like Sea of Thieves, but with much more of a focus on PvP. It even has a Battle Royale mode, which is pretty cool. I actually think a Battle Royale mode would be perfect for a game like Sea of Thieves, so it's nice that they thought of that and threw it in here. Anyway, if you'd like to do a deep dive to discover all there is to discover about Blazing Sails, you can check it out for yourself by following the links below. But for the purposes of this video, we're going to jump in, have a look at what's available for the characters itself, for the ship, and all the rest. I am also just going to say that I'm looking at like the vanilla version of the game, so you just buy the base game, and this is what you get. I didn't buy any cosmetics or anything like that, so I will mention them, but I'm not specifically going to be showing them off here in this video. I will show some of them off in the trailers and stuff, but I don't have them in my possession, is what I'm saying. Now, we're going to jump in by having a look at the pirate customization first. It's a little limited, but there is at least some stuff that you can do, and I appreciate the options that they did put in here. And can I tell you something? I appreciate the fact that they let you have direct control of your pirate's body. It's like, I mean, I sat there in Sea of Thieves with their infinite pirate generator, and I generated pirates for like 3 hours straight, and I still didn't find one that I liked. That's just how it is. And that's obviously making the best of a bad situation in Sea of Thieves. You're meant to look scrappy and scrawny and a little piratey. In this, they actually give you a bit more control over it, and that's cool. So yeah, here you get to choose your body type. You get to choose male or female. And then you will notice that there's a whole lot more down here. These are the DLC stuff. And the game is super cheap, but you can buy extra packs that give you all sorts of different appearances. Skeletons, pirate skeletons, glowy ghost skeletons, all sorts of stuff. But if you play in the regular base version, you only have these options. And then for male, you get to pick scrawny, average, and strong. Female gets the same, scrawny, average, strong. Pretty cool. You will note that the skin tones are the same. The tattoo colors are the same no matter which you're on here. Nothing really changes, so we'll just go on male for now, and we'll look at the skin tones. I am a big fan of the amount of skin tones that they give us here. It's a fantastic selection. It's awesome. They have warmer tones, they have the cooler tones, they have some slightly different ones here, and they do go pretty dark. It's good. Yeah, there's really nothing to complain about here. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Tattoo colors. I'll show you some tattoos as we go through this. You will see a couple of examples of them when I get to the level section, where you can see the stuff that you earn from leveling. But as it stands, and on your basic character, you don't have any tattoos right at the start. So those are the colors you can have, but there are no tattoos right at the start. Just keep that in mind. If you wanted to see the different skin colors on the female, here we go. It's mostly the same. You're not going to see much of a difference, but for completion's sake, we'll show it to you. There you go. It's okay. It's okay. Then, voices. Let's give them a listen. I'm actually a big fan of the voices. I think that this is a good use of voice pitch. There's a pitch bar here. You get male 1 and male 2, female 1, female 2, and you get to change the pitch. So I'm going to stop talking for a little while, and I'll give you an example of each of them, and we can discuss after.
I marked a location. Fire the right cannons! Enemy spotted in the east.
Fire the right cannons! Enemy spotted in the west. Enemy spotted in the north. I marked the location. Over there! Enemy spotted in the east.
We're sinking! Enemy spotted in the west.
We're sinking! Boom! Headshot! Fire the right cannon! Fire the right cannons! Fire the left cannons!
Enemy spotted in the east! Repair the hull! Enemy spotted in the west! Enemy spotted in the west! Enemy spotted in the southeast! Enemy spotted in the southwest!
Boom! Headshot! Enemy spotted in the west!
Enemy spotted okay. In the south!
We're sinking! I marked a location.
Enemy spotted in the northwest!
Take the wheel! Repair the hull! Fire the right cannons!
Enemy spotted in the south!
In the face, matey!
Enemy spotted in the southeast! Repair the hull! Man the capstan!
Enemy spotted in the north! Enemy spotted in the east! Enemy spotted in the southeast!
There you go. So I say it's a good use of pitch because compared to other games that I've seen using this system, it sounds almost natural when you move the pitch up. You can hear a slight like chipmunky effect and you can sort of hear that it's doctored, you know, that the pitch has been changed, but it's as close as it gets to natural. In other words, they used a good sort of, let's say, recipe to increase the pitch. Oftentimes the voices get like tinny or robotic, or they go way too fast and then sounds unnatural, or you know, any number of other things. And this is actually a decent system. It's a decent way that they've done it. I don't know what they did to make it sound decent, but for me, if I listen to it and I pick either the male or the female ones with the high pitch, it actually still sounds sort of believable and it makes sense. It sort of sounds like a gnomish voice or something like that, but I think it's natural enough to be able to be usable without sounding completely out of place. So yeah, I mean, I can't believe I'm saying this, but I'm probably most impressed by the voices in this whole thing. They're crisp, they're clear, well acted, and there seems to be a whole lot of different voice commands and stuff that you can use. So yeah, I mean, that's a plus. I'm a fan. There you go. You gotta appreciate the little things, man. You gotta appreciate the little things. That brings us to the end of the default body and pirate customization. Here you get to pick a bunch of different hammers. It's basically, I want to say it's cosmetic stuff. And this stuff you get when you level. So like you get different versions of hammers that you can equip, cooler looking ones, more ornate looking ones, and so on and so forth. Then here you have your titles. So if you want to check these out, you can just pause and have a peek. You get these by leveling as well. So there's a lot of stuff that you can get by just playing the game, right? Then there's ones that you can get by winning as well, which is cool. Yeah, it's cool. These are your, I don't know, this must be emotes maybe? Or perhaps something that goes on with your ship? Or I'm not even really sure. There's no real like pop-up that says what this is, but I imagine it's something like an emote. That's what's like, what is it? Like, so it can't be a pet, because like, There's weapons here, then there's like skulls and tentacles and bat wings, but they are obviously status things where you need a certain amount of wins to get them, so that's cool. That's cool. Then on to like cosmetics over here, in terms of cosmetics, these are ones that you will fill out when you buy packs. So basically, if you jump in and you buy one of the supporter packs that are available, then you get a whole lot of different stuff here that you can use. And that's actually where I'm going to sort of squeeze this in now. I'm going to show you here on the main menu that there are a bunch of different packs that give you lots of different bits and pieces. Now, each picture that you look at here is split into different parts. So as an example, this one with these characters here, you can see that the beards and the outfits and the other cool little bits and pieces that they have on them, you can mix and match them to make the character outfit that you want. These are the skeletal skins that you can get. Here's a ship skin with a very, very cool looking pirate skin. And there's obviously, as you can see here, different beards and stuff that you can get. And that's cool as well. Here's different headgear, different weapons, and all sorts of other stuff. This one actually has like some barnacles on and like tentacles twisted around it. Really cool looking, really cool. And you'll see this in some of the promotional footage that I put up on the screen as well. And then there's some like conquistadors or something, I don't know what that is. And all that stuff gets put in here. So for the moment, all you really have is that and this, or bald. And then this is just to like filter stuff, I think. So it's like the colors, I don't know. I don't have any colors, apparently. There's mustache and just regular eyebrows. I think this is like a dye. I'm not sure what this one is. I don't know. This must be facial expressions or something like that. It's like the mouth and the nose or whatever, and this is the eyes. Again, they don't really have any notes on what this stuff is, so it's kind of strange. You just have to guess what it is. And then this is again the hair. The tops, the bottoms, you have two different choices here. You will notice that the male and female obviously look a little different where that's concerned. The pants are the same, but obviously you have that there. You can't completely take it off. I'm not exactly sure what this is about, but yeah. Then your right glove, right foot, left foot. And that's about it for the pirate customization. It's a limited amount of things, but you do unlock a bunch when you level, so just keep that in mind as we go through here. We're first going to look at the ship, then we'll jump into looking at the level stuff. The ship, you first get to choose the different types of ship. So this is the bomb vessel. It's a mortar ship with average speed and maneuverability. It's kind of cool. Difficulty advanced. I love how they let you just look at the ship here and rotate it and like fully inspect it and stuff. It's really cool. Then your stats are over here if you care about that kind of stuff. You can see everything here on the right hand side. Then you've got the caravel. This one's also a mortar ship with average speed and maneuverability. I don't know if it's supposed to. Did it change? Did it not change? Oh yeah, okay, they're the same. It's just sort of a different description. It's like a bigger version of that one. Once again, there's the number of positions, number of cannons, all the stats that you could need there. And the customizations will obviously look a little different on each ship. Here we have the Brigantine. It's a sturdy ship boasting a good amount of firepower. 4 cannons on this one. There you go. Once again, stats on the right-hand side. Junk ship. This is my favorite. Yeah. This is agile and fast. Yeah, because why not? And you can see it's sort of patched together and stuff there. And then we're back at the start. You will notice that I've already looked at the customization options. I've got a South African flag flying there. You get to pick basically different customization for the two flags. The one's your pirate flag, and I kind of appreciate this. The one's your pirate flag, and the other one is your nationality. And you can just pick anything. It's literally, I'm going to scroll through here slowly. It's literally got all the flags. I know there's going to be one person in chat saying like, oh, you know, they screwed me over. They don't have my country's flag. And that's probably going to be the case. Just like report a bug or whatever and tell them your flag is missing. And if they don't put it in, then there's probably a reason they didn't put it in. But for the most part, it seems like they got a really good selection of flags here. Not all of them are actual, like, you know, country flags. There are some made up ones thrown in here as well. And yeah, I mean, that's cool. That's really cool. I'm a big fan of the massive selection they have, and it looks good. It looks really good. That looks like One Piece, actually, doesn't it? Bunch of flags. So yeah, you can really like go ham with this. Pick what you want. Then, as you can see, you get to choose the prow of your ship. You get to choose the lanterns. I don't have any available. You even get to choose the rigging and the ropes, which is sick. The planks, I guess. The two sails. You get to put the skull and crossbones on them, and then you get to do the colors. And all of this stuff you obviously pick up and gain when you level and when you play the game and when you buy those supporter packs. You get to choose the name of your ship over here. You can random it or actually type it in if you'd like. And yeah, on this customization over here, it's this stuff. This is the last thing I wanted to show off, and I wanted to show it off because, like, it's kind of interesting, and it makes the ship look a little more unique. But basically you can have the paint on the hull wear off. You can't see that here because I've got no paint on the hull, but you can have the sails wear off, which I think is kind of nice. It's a nice effect that they have here. Then you can have the sails torn a little bit, which I think is once again nice, and you can put dirt on the sails. Then there's the configurations. It's color configurations. So once again, I hate to say it, but I don't really have anything to show you here because, once again, the base game doesn't have anything with it. But you get the idea. It'll basically allow you to switch the colors around, mix and match them. And then it's the same with the flags, where you can have both pirate flags, one of each, or switch them around the other way. Cool. Yeah, and each of the ships has a slightly different version of this customization because, obviously, the sails look different. The hull and the ship itself looks different. It'll all look a little, well, unique. So yeah, you got a bunch of choices there. And honestly, I think it's all right. It's not a lot, once again, as I've mentioned now. But when you do jump in, and that's my perfect segue into the next section, and you look at the levels and stuff like that, then there'll be a lot of stuff that you can earn. So that little picture of the mouth, you know, where you could put the beard and stuff on, it seems like you can put a knife in your mouth, which is pretty cool. It's a nice little extra. And these are the levels. There's a lot of them. I'm just going to show you. It's like all the way up here to 225. And as we go through here, you'll see there's like a knife in the mouth. There's a different hammer. There's a cool beard. Title. That must be something for your mouth as well. Another hammer. that looks like a coconut bra, which is kind of cool. I'm not sure what the difference is, the distinction between the golden one and the regular one. I don't know. You're going to have to figure that out for yourself. We're looking at the stuff here. There's another title. There's a monocle. There's a belt that says booty. That's kind of sick. It's like a map hat or something. I don't know. There's a bunch of really cool stuff here. And as I was saying, like, this is fine. If they let you earn this stuff for free and they don't ask you to buy this separately, it's a good system. Because it actually gives you something for playing the game. Yeah, I mean, like, I'm personally a fan of that. I like when games don't ask you to buy the game and then still spend money on the game. I think that's a little ridiculous. But it is obviously the world we live in, so any little bit that you get for free nowadays is a bonus. Here's a nice prow for the ship. There's a really cool looking beard. I'm not sure where you get the dyes and stuff like that. That must also be from somewhere like this. Maybe it's just loot that you pick up in the game. I don't know the full system that they have. You actually get two hook hands there, which is kind of nice. Pirate King title. Here's the cool stuff that starts popping up. Different sail patterns and stuff like that. Fleet Commander, Talk of the Town, gloves. These are torches. And then here at the end, you actually get this massively cool red and sort of gold jacket. So yeah, a lot of stuff that you can get from the leveling over there. And that does bring us to the end of this video. So personally, I think that this art style is pretty cool. It's very reminiscent of Sea of Thieves, obviously, but they give you a little bit more control over your pirate from the get-go. Even though there's not a lot to get right at the start and customize and work with, you can buy the supporter packs because the game is pretty cheap and the supporter packs are just a little bit extra on top of that. So if you want to support the devs or whatever, if you're enjoying the game, you can pick that up. And then on top of that, the level rewards do seem to be pretty cool and they are definitely numerous and varied. There's a lot going on here. So, I mean, even though, again, it's pretty bare bones when it comes to the actual customization options for both the pirate and the ship, I think that they'll give you enough post-creation to make things interesting. And it does seem like you can customize your character at any point, which is kind of fun. So there you go. I hope this video was useful. One complaint I have is that when you click on these packs here, if you bought the game on Steam, you get taken to the Epic Store. So that's something they might want to look at because you know, if you see something you like here, you click on it and you're in the Steam version, you don't want to go to the Epic Store. That's a grievous wrongdoing right there. Anyway, that's me done. I'd love to hear from you guys what you think of Blazing Sails, if you're playing it, if you're enjoying it, if you've bought any packs, if you've customized your pirate, if you made it look cool, and all the rest. If you'd like to support me and what I do, you can find some links below. My Ko-fi website, Twitch stream, all the rest. And as always, you can give this one a like and share it and do all that other good stuff. Most importantly though, happy customizing those characters, dudes. Happy that.